Greetings. Brother, you have been very polite and civil, and I thank you. But you have said the following, and it is I who must explain to you. I think that perhaps the best way to reply to both your posts is to explain a few things about Islam and Quran. My initial response to this was the following. Bless your heart, brother. There is nothing which can be said to explain Islam and Quran which will ever make it a true message from the God who raised Jesus from the dead and healed my kidney. If you had read my post, you would be staring this unchangeable reality in the face. I will gladly accept death before I reject the Son of God. Revelation 12:1. And they overcame him because of the blood of the Lamb, and because of the word of their testimony, and they did not love their life, even when faced with death. And this dear brother, deceived by Islam, responded with the following. Well, Texas, I have read your posts, and it's because I do read your posts that I said I will explain Islam and Quran. Of course not in detail. You see, Texas, the intent here is not in any way to try to make you accept Islam or reject Jesus. Why? Because none of us Muslims can guide anyone to Islam. How do we know that? Because of these. And then he proceeded to list several ayat from Muhammad's Quran. The problem is the unknowing deception of his statement. The intent here is not in any way to try and make you accept Islam or reject Jesus. In fact, that is exactly the reason to argue for Muhammad's religion. But as I said, there is no statement which can make Islam correct. So I began to struggle with how to possibly teach this brother the true reality about Islam in terms that he can understand. In our minds, we have this notion of goodness and badness. Pause a moment and just think about it. We imagine good people that we know, people who have been kind to us, people who we have seen obey the law, teachers, for example, who helped us learn and grow. We always have a hard time answering when someone asks, would God send someone good like Gandhi to hell? And I think that reveals our own bias in our thinking. Without realizing it, we really think that good people deserve to go to heaven. And the inverse corollary is that we think bad people deserve to go to hell. Our minds further get clouded by thinking God only wants good people to go to heaven. And likewise, Satan is only trying to trick bad people into hell with him. And that is where we are wrong in our thinking. Number one, God wants all men to be saved. 1 Timothy 2:3. This is good and acceptable in the sight of God, our Savior, who desires all men to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. And I'm not going to go off on a tangent about Calvinism and the elect few. Number two, none of us deserve salvation. We are all sinners. Isaiah 53:6, all of us, like sheep, have gone astray. Each of us has turned to his own way, and the Lord has caused the iniquity of us all to fall on him. Romans 5:12. Therefore, just as through one man sin entered into the world, and death through sin, and so death spread to all men, because all sinned. Romans 3:23. For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. So somehow we need to kill the idea in our heads that there are good people who deserve heaven on their own merits. Ephesians 2:8, for by grace you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God. not as the result of works, meaning your own works, so that no one may boast. You see, brother, if any man could claim, I earned my salvation, I deserve to enter heaven for eternity, he would be guilty of pride, which is a sin. But more than that, he would be setting himself over God. God, you have no right to judge me. God, if you judge me undeserving, you are wrong. Therefore, salvation can never be earned, as the Word of God says. So none of us are good. Therefore, God is not trying to save only good people, because there are none good. Even Jesus, when called good, said, Mark 10:18, "Why do you call me good?" Jesus asked him. "Nobody is good except for one, God." And that is when my idea began to formulate. God is trying to save all men, even bad men. And Satan is not just trying to damn bad men. Bad men seem ready to commit sin and yield to the ease and pleasure of sin. They are just closer to, or perhaps more honest, regarding our true nature as fallen creatures. So Satan's real goal is to damn good men, damn especially those who would seek God. Because those who seek God essentially reject the evil that Satan offers. Those with a conscience intact obey the law. You see, they have an inner moral law. Romans 2:12, "For when Gentiles who do not have the law by nature do what the law requires, they are a law to themselves, even though they do not have the law." This is our conscience placed in all men by God. So what does this have to do with Islam? Well, brother, the way for Satan to damn a good man is not to tempt him to murder, is not to tempt him to become a drunk, is not to tempt him with crack cocaine, is not to tempt him with whores and cigarettes. No, brother, a man with a conscience has an inner law. You tempt that man to his damnation with a good-sounding religion. You tempt his desire to seek God with a false religion that claims to follow an Allah. You see, a sincere person will sincerely follow a religion that claims to be a true path from and to Allah. And this, brother, is exactly the deception and scheme of Al-Makr. I want you to really understand this, brother. You want to explain Islam to me, brother. But I already know Islam. Islam is Satan's scheme, brother. Islam is not a correction. The message of the prophets is correct and coherent and completed. But Satan must claim Islam is a correction, brother, because Satan must change God's true message of salvation, and a correction is a change that sounds good. If Satan said, "I am Satan, follow me to hell," not one sincere person would submit to him. But if Satan says, "I am Allah, submit to me and worship me," sincere men and women will follow him to hell. They will submit out of ignorance, and it will damn them, and Satan will have his victory over them. This is Islam, brother. This is the religion that you sincerely follow. Of this, there can be no doubt. The murderers of ISIS follow Islam. and think they are the best of Muslims. The murderers of ISIS think they serve Allah. The things they do cause any man with a conscience to gag. They follow Muhammad, brother, make no mistake. And if you still have a conscience, you flinch at what they do. God may be calling to your heart, brother, trying to guide you. The God who made heaven and earth does not require or command this evil in his name. I pray that God will speak to you in your dreams, brother. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.